Hangi şirketler adına ekonomik tetikçi olarak görev yaptınız?
Well, I really worked for one company, Charles T. Maine, which was a consulting firm in Boston. We had about 2,000 employees. My title was chief economist. I had about 50 people working for me. And we were a very powerful consulting firm, but not well known at all. We were very undercover, so to speak. We were legal, but we stayed out of the limelight. And as a consulting firm, we worked for many other corporations. But a lot of my work was for the World Bank, the International Monetary Fund, the Asian Development Bank, the Inter-American Development Bank, and a lot of big banks.
Peki dünyaya egemen olan finans baronlarını, patronlarını ne zaman fark ettiniz?
You know, it's interesting because when I went to business school and studied economics, you know, we studied classical economics, supply and demand curves and all of this sort of thing. And I believe that I was taught that a way to help a developing country develop was to invest a lot of money into infrastructure. Power plants, industrial parks, highways. Then when I got out in the business world and started doing this, at the beginning I believed that was all correct. But the more I got into it, the more I understood that really what it was about was creating a new type of empire that was run by the big business barons, what we call the corporatocracy. But that wasn't ever taught in schools, and it still isn't. I had to learn that from personal experience. So I did it as I was on the job. I began to understand that these loans that we were making to these countries really weren't helping the countries at all. They were helping our own businesses, especially some of the big wealthy families, the famous 1%, which is really more like 0.0001%. And they were not helping the people in these countries at all. They were just a few wealthy people that were corroborators with the 1%, with the corporatocracy. But that's never taught, and I had to dig beneath the surface to really understand that.
Büyük Britanya finans imparatorluğu için ne düşünüyorsunuz?
Fascinating, this whole concept that in recent times we know that the control of LIBOR and the control of many of the indices has come out of London, and we're seeing this now with the devaluation here in Turkey, the control that the London banking system has. But you know, it's coming through London, but those banks are also very closely tied with the US Federal Reserve and Wall Street. So there's this very tight family there of people that control the big banks, whether it's in New York or London or Hong Kong in the past, you know, Tokyo. There's this system, and it seems to these days be funneled through London more than anywhere else. But that's just, I believe that's just the funneling point. And the system is much greater than that. It's like an octopus. And so you might say that the head of the octopus is in London, but the tentacles reach out everywhere.
İngiltere eski başbakanı Tony Blair neden ben Katolik oldum dedikten sonra istifa etti? Orada bir mesaj mı vardı?
Well, I think it's hard for me to speak to that because I don't have any personal experience there. But I think Blair in a way overextended himself. He made some tactical mistakes. And at the same time, things were falling apart around the world. We had the recession going on. And I think, in a way, I believe that Blair got burned out. I think he had enough, personally. I think he was ready to get out. And I think the announcement of him being Catholic was part of his plan just to make himself less attractive. I really think Blair was tired. I also think there was a lot of pressure being put on him to get out because he'd become quite controversial, maybe a little too controversial.
Rockefeller ve Rothschild aileleri sizin için neyi ifade ediyor, neyi çağrıştırıyor?
Well, we know that they've been very powerful for many, many years and continue to be very powerful. I am not a person who really buys into the conspiracy theory, the Bilderberger theory, this theory that there's a few people that control everything. I know the Bilderberger group exists, there's no question. They have a lot of power, there's no question about that. But I believe that the system is a little bit more complex than that. So while the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds do have a great deal of power, including controlling a lot of the banking interests, and being involved with the Federal Reserve in the United States, I also think that a lot of the power simply comes from the fact that corporations today, all of the big corporations, are driven by this one policy of maximizing profits regardless of the social and environmental costs. And they don't actually have to get together and conspire, the heads of the companies don't have to get together and conspire to do anything illegal. There doesn't have to be a conspiracy. But what happens when any law is threatened to be passed in any powerful country, or in any country for that matter, the corporations come together. So Nike and Reebok may compete for our dollars in the store, but if there's a law that comes up, whether it's in Turkey or in the United States, that threatens their ability to maximize profits, they become partners. And they bring their lobbyists to bear, and they bring their money to bear to make sure that law doesn't happen. Also, we might say that Chevron and Exxon or Shell compete for your to sell you gas at the gas pump. But if there's a law that's threatening them, their profits anywhere in the world, they'll all come together and organize. And I think it's very interesting, in the United States in the last few years, we've had what we call stalemate in Congress, where Congress can't vote on anything. That's intentional. So the big corporations and the corporatocracy finance both the Republicans and the Democrats. And they tell the Democrats to vote yes on a certain bill, and they tell the Republicans to vote no, knowing that if they do that, there will be no passage of any new laws. The existing laws favor the corporatocracy, so to a certain degree, the stonewalling, the stopping any passage in Congress of any progressive laws works to their advantage. They want that to happen. They want our Congress in the United States basically to be impotent, emasculated, to not have any power, to not be able to make decisions, because right now the laws favor them and they don't want to see that change. And go on further to say, I think we're seeing something similar in Europe, that the big corporations do not want a strong European Union. They do not want a strong European Union.